Good morning. Sunday, 17th of May, 2020. And after 8 weeks of lockdown, we can now travel in England to take exercise. It's been a week since we could do that, but this is an opportunity for me to go and do it now. 8 weeks. 8 weeks. I've been working from home for those 8 weeks. I think it's eight. Probably about eight. 23rd of March. So it's about 8 weeks. I've been working from home. And generally obeying the requirements of the lockdown, so I have behaved myself. And boy, have I missed being able to get out of my bike. Especially over the Easter and May weekend, when we had glorious weather. That really was a challenge, not to just go out. But I've behaved. And finally, on this lovely morning, a chance to get out. Unfortunately, a week tomorrow, we would have been heading off to do the first part of the World Atlantic Way trip, the southern section. But unfortunately, that's all cancelled now. And within the next week, I've got to cancel the second trip, which was for the first week in July, because don't look like that's going to happen either. So, a bit sad. But can't be helped, I suppose. So I was debating whether to ring around a few people or WhatsApp a few of my mates, Kevin, Alan, Joe and everybody. But I think really the guidance is don't be in groups, be on your own. So on this occasion I'm just going to do it on my own. And hopefully next week will be a better opportunity for maybe us all to get together next weekend. So strange old times, and I've been working from home, so it's not affected me really from a financial point of view. And I've done everything I've needed to do from home. I do while I was in the office, so not really any problems on that front. And we use Microsoft Teams, which is really good. I have lots of face-to-face meetings if you want them, and I think we're all getting becoming the new normal for us, and working out quite well. So I don't actually know where I'm going this morning. I woke up debating which direction to go in, and I'm thinking of just probably heading down towards the Welsh border and just skimming along you for a little while, probably down towards maybe Knighton. Have a look, get up to the Welsh border. The middle finger up to the coppers or the border guards if they're there. Only joking. And then turn around and come back. But the other downside of this is I can't get to my caravan. So that's a bit of a pain. And it is a bit of a bind now, not really seeing the family properly. It's nice to see them. On the then another positive, lots of DIY getting done, garden getting landscaped. So there's using it hopefully to something positive. Well, the other thing is, well, I've learned how to cut my hair, so I never need to get the barbers again. So that's probably how much I pay for an haircut, 15 quid, probably five times a year. There you go, that's probably about 75 quid a year I'm going to save in haircuts. Fortunately it's only one style, which is number two. But then again, my air doesn't take the styles anyway. So, that should make life nice and easy. And hopefully, now we've got this bit of freedom, we can get a few trips and decent ride-outs in to compensate for the not being able to do the trips this year. So I know the first week in July, because we've pretty much booked it off, I think the plan is just to do a few ride-outs. So I'll have a look at that. I've got a few ideas of places we could probably go. So, as I say, I'll have a look at that. It's quite strange when I was sort of this morning, I was lying in bed thinking about going out. I was actually debating not going out. So, the horrible thing is that this plumbing lockdown sort of makes you institutionalised towards it being the norm. Which I realised this morning, shall I go and ride my bike or shall I stay in and do some work in the garden? What a ridiculous thing to be thinking. Unfortunately, I think that's how it gets you a little bit. Hopefully I've snapped out of that nonsense now. I'm going to get back ready to move the bikes around in the garage because I haven't been out on the Tiger since I took it for its service back in October. Would have been out Monday for the War Atlantic Way, so I need to get that out and ride it. I'll do that when I get back. Here's the opportunity to move around in the garage. Lovely neck of the woods down here. To joggers and cyclists out. Thought of taking up cycling. Thought it didn't last long, of course. But I thought about it. I'm getting my exercise from the work I'm doing in the garden. Oh, I love this bike. Nice to get some plumbing country air into your lungs as well. Squirrel. There's just not many cars around. I think it's about 9:15. I'm not quite sure what the time is. I think it's about 9:15. Some vehicles here. Oh, what they're for. Few of the motor vloggers who I'm sort of following and who I chat and engage with are not able to do their trips either this year. A real bummer this is. What I am holding out a bit of hope for is that maybe later, maybe August time, we might get a bit of freedom. At least we can do a short trip, maybe if it's just somewhere in England, maybe I'll do a short trip. So I'm keeping fingers crossed for that. At least to do one, even if it's a couple of nights. That'd be nice. I hope these pubs can survive. I really do. Quite a British way of life, really. To see them going, that'll be very sad state of affairs. Oh, just coming into Bewdley. Lovely Bewdley. Lovely day, really is. Beautiful weather. of Bewdley and on the way to Leominster now. Look at that. Fantastic. Oh, flippin' love it. This is a road from Tenbury Wells to Bromyard. Lovely road. Just freestyling it, not really plans on going anywhere, just a general direction. So I've been down to Bromyard, down to Leominster, build up, and up through Richard's Castle. Just taking a picture outside All Saints Church, and now I'm back on the road. Where's this? Overton. I'm just following my nose really today. What a beautiful day. Perfect. The back roads of Shropshire. Lovely. Tree tunnel. Lentwardine. Ah, that's where we want to be. Thank you. Boyce's place. Love this hedge. Thank you. just look at that. Oh, that's the last port of call for today. A whistle stop visit to Long Mynd. I'm going to head back home via Bridgnorth. Much Wenlock and Bridgnorth. Really enjoyable day. Of course, a chance to use the Thruxton R. Really nice. I'm going to move it around the garage this afternoon. I want to bring the Tiger to the front so I can take that out next time. So I'll wash this and then move them around a bit. Absolutely loads of bikes out today, as I would expect there to be. Hey mate. What an awesome view. Can you imagine, this is really heavy on the wrists. Ah, Jesus. I love the way this bike purrs, I really do. Purrs and just tons of torque. I love it. Just the ability to do that. No effort whatsoever. I don't think I've got to put my earplugs in yet again. So I think I'm going to wrap the video up for today. If you stuck to the end, thanks for watching. I hope you found it entertaining. And fingers crossed that we are starting to get back to normal now, and we can start to do our trips and things. But I think one thing we can be pretty sure of is that we can ride our bikes out on weekends now, and go and do some sort of sightseeing, and just generally just enjoy riding our bikes. So on that note, I'll say thanks for watching, and hopefully you'll all be able to get out and do what we do most in the coming weeks and months. See you soon.